Watch what happens when you put this bit of plastic into the oven.
Whoa!
It shrunk to a third of its original size.
And got 9 times thicker. This is shrinking plastic. It can be turned into fridge magnets, key rings, necklaces, and pins. The best part is that you can use recycled plastic. Want to see how it works? Then let's get scienced. To make these at home, you will need some colored pencils, a permanent marker, scissors, shrinking plastic, and some magnets, key rings, string, or pins. You can pick up the shrinking plastic from some craft stores, or you can buy it online. It's a type of plastic called polystyrene. Usually we think of polystyrene as the light, foamy, bubbly stuff that we find in bean bags or used as packaging around electronics. But polystyrene also comes as clear thin sheets and is sometimes used for takeaway containers. This means you don't have to buy your shrinking plastic. Just have a look in your recycling bin to see if there's any in there. To check if your plastic is polystyrene, look for its resin identification number. That's the number inside the triangle made from 3 arrows. Polystyrene will have the number 6. Now that we've got the shrinking plastic, we're ready to go. If you're using recycled polystyrene, give one side a light sand with some fine sandpaper. The shrinking plastic will already come with one rough side. Draw or trace your design onto the rough side of the plastic using the colored pencils. Remember, this will become 3 times smaller. So a good size for your drawing is about 10 centimeters, unless you want to make something larger or smaller, which is fine as well. Then go around the edges with a thin permanent marker. You can skip this step if you want, but I like how it looks with an outline. The next step is to cut them out. You can cut the plastic with a regular pair of scissors. It's up to you if you want to cut along the lines of your drawing or if you want to cut a shape around it. I did 4 drawings in total and I'm going to make something different out of each one. I'm making a fridge magnet with Pikachu and a pin with Squirtle, so I don't need to make any changes with them. I'm making a key ring with Charmander, so I need to punch a hole 1.25 centimeters from the edge of the plastic. I'm making a necklace with Bulbasaur, so I need to punch 2 holes 1.25 centimeters from the edge of the plastic and 2.5 centimeters apart. Now for the fun part, making them shrink. Preheat your oven to 200 degrees Celsius. Place your drawings on some nonstick paper on an oven tray. And then get an adult to put this in the oven. After 10 seconds, the plastic will start to shrink. Some of the drawings might twist and turn as they shrink, but don't worry, they should lay back down flat if you wait long enough. Once they've shrunk, get an adult to take them out of the oven and wait for 2 minutes for them to cool down. This is a before and after shot of each one. How cool do they look? To protect your drawings, you can add a layer of clear varnish. Something like Mod Podge works well. Don't worry, it dries clear. Now we're going to turn them into some pretty cool things. Use some hot glue to attach a magnet to the back of Pikachu. That's how you make a fridge magnet. Use some hot glue to attach the flat side of the pin to the back of Squirtle. This is how your pin should look. Use some pliers to open the last link of the keychain. Then put it through this hole and bend the link shut. Now you've got a really cool keychain. Cut a piece of string and thread it through these holes, then tie these ends together. This is the perfect gift for that special person in your life. So why does this plastic shrink? Polystyrene is a polymer, which means it's made up of a long chain of identical molecules all joined together. Let's use these rubber bands to represent a chain of polystyrene. Polystyrene is often made as a sheet of plastic with all of these chains bunched up around each other. This sheet can then be heated and turned into all different shapes. It can even be stretched out into a thinner sheet. If cooled quickly, these polymers are locked in this new position. They don't want to be stretched like this, but they can't move. This stretched plastic is what we drew our pictures on. The plastic softens in the oven and the polymers are able to return to their original position, making the drawing smaller in the process. If you used recycled polystyrene, you might have noticed that it shrunk more in one direction than the other. That's because that bit of polystyrene was stretched more in one direction when it was heated. You can try looking for a different piece of polystyrene or drawing something that you only want to shrink in one direction. I hope you have fun trying this at home. Thanks for watching. I'll see you next time on Silly Science with Simon.